Remember, we said that sperm will be formed within the seminiferous tubules, and sperm production is tied together with meiosis, which we discussed in the previous chapter. I'm not interested in you learning the names. For any of you that may go on to anatomy and physiology, then you'll learn these specific names. But the idea I want to point out is cell division. We start with a 2N or a diploid cell, and one question you may have is, well, why don't male run out of sperm? And the answer is before a potential sperm cell called a germ cell undergoes meiosis, it first undergoes mitosis to produce a replacement. So males are constantly replacing cells that undergo the process of meiosis. So we start again with our 2N cell. That 2N cell will undergo meiosis, one, reductional division, to produce two cells that are 1N. Then we have meiosis 2, which is equational division. And this is where the math can drive students crazy. They go, wait a minute, how does a 1N separate into two 1N cells? Why isn't it 1/2N, 1/2N? Remember, this cell is haploid in regards to chromosome number, but each chromosome is duplicated. So when you separate, each of these cells will get one sister chromatid from each of the chromosomes in the haploid cell. So that's why these daughter cells are 1N. Then these will undergo within the seminiferous tubule the process of differentiation to produce what we regard as the mature sperm cell or spermatozoa. And these are the cells that will be capable of fertilization. Note the head, which will contain the haploid DNA, the neck, which contains the mitochondria to produce the ATP energy, and then we have the flagellum, which will provide mobility for the sperm cell.